20 days, 6 months, 2 years, 5 years. People are not difficult to win. It's just that we offend them. And so they put up walls. And then we can't reach them. Be inviting. Let them think that you are bait. Because you are. You are bait on a glorified hook. Can I hear an amen? And when they grab you, God pulls. Be inviting. Then he says, you are like a snake. Look at your face. See your face? Look at your face. See, now that's the problem. You've been taught that snakes are evil, demonic, devilish. And yet Jesus says, be like a snake. Here is Jesus, God in the flesh, telling you to be like a snake. So what I did was I studied snakes. Are you tampering with my microphone? Just set it and leave it, please. It's very important for you to understand then that it's very critical to study a snake, because he said, for you to witness to people, you must become like a snake. So let's learn some things from a snake. And I was shocked to find out when I studied a snake how wise a serpent is. Here's how you win people. Number one, and I have it crawling in because I want you to feel it a little bit, all right? Yeah. And that's how you're supposed to win people. You don't jump in, ta-da, I'm here to get you saved. Snakes don't jump around. What do snakes do? They slither into situations. You're supposed to show up and they don't know you arrive until it's too late. You ever came upon a snake? You walk up to people without being threatening to them. And of course, if you're going to slither in without being threatening, that means you can come at least with a smile. When you smile with me right away, I know you're not threatening me. How many believers go witnessing with a long face? You're sitting one next to one. Don't look right now. But it's incredible how people look when they, all of a sudden they take spiritual look. You know, they, you know, praise the Lord. Okay, let's study the snake. Number one, very important. Snake, first of all, has the ability of camouflage. Camouflage means that the snake can change its colors to adapt to the environment. Christ says if you're going to win people, you must first of all be like a snake. And that means you have to fit in. It's important that you don't walk around with a collar backwards and a big chain around your neck going street witnessing. You don't walk around with a black tie and a coat suit and a nice shiny shoe with a big Bible 10 feet large walking to people's doors. He says you're supposed to fit in. That's why we have to dress casual. And whatever they are wearing, you kind of put on something that doesn't shock them. You got to fit in with the environment. And then the other thing is you can camouflage your language. You talk their language. Camouflage. The snake has that powerful ability to blend into the environment. Number two, the snake has the ability to enter any situation. Now, you know, it's amazing. When I was growing up in Baintown, snakes could find holes under the floor that was smaller than their bodies. How many of you have seen those snakes? You say, now how did that snake get in there? Well, you see, the snake has the ability to enter any situation it decides to go into. It can twist its body and unconnect its joints so that it can make it through. Christ says, be like that. Be able to adapt and accommodate and be able to fit into any environment. Most believers can only live in church. When they leave the confines of a church environment, they don't know what to do. That's why you're afraid to witness. Because you believe you got to be a certain way to witness. No, you got to be able to be like a snake. Enter any environment. You know, I have so much fun witnessing and bringing people to Christ. Every day I bring people to Christ. And it's because I do not make myself obnoxious or conspicuous. To be able to fit in and talk to anyone about any subject. And that's why it's important for you to become a wide-read person. Someone who knows a lot of different information about different areas of life. Because you'll be able to fit in. How many pastors cannot witness to politicians? Because they keep saying hallelujah too much. How many ministers and teachers and doctors cannot witness to a nurse or to a mechanic because you keep talking all this spiritual talk? How do you fit in to any situation? And then number three, snake have no fear of the size of their prey. Say amen. You know, have you ever seen a snake so small swallow a big rat? I saw a snake the other day on National Geographic. It swallowed a pig. And I mean, the pig made the stomach of the snake big. You can see the pig moving down the body, you know. And this snake face is so small. Now, what they say the snake does is the snake unlocks its jaws. And whatever the size of the prey is, its skin stretches to capture the size. Now, who made that snake? God. And who's speaking in this verse? God. God says, look, I want you to be as wise. That means apply the knowledge of a snake. Don't ever say, that person will never listen to me. He says, stop it. You could eat them. They are food for you. Your boss needs Jesus. Your supervisor is not God. She needs God. Your principal of the school is not bigger than God. Even though you may be a young teacher to just start working there. That's your pig and you are the snake. He says, don't be afraid to talk to anybody about the kingdom. That's what he's talking about. No one impresses me. You know, a snake is never impressed by the size of the prey. The snake knows, whatever size that is, I could adjust my mouth and stretch my skin to handle that. Don't be afraid of anyone that you see. Don't be afraid of anyone that you see. Don't be afraid. You ladies, you see some man on the street, see him big and rough. Hey, just say to him, you're mine today. You are food for the kingdom. Matter of fact, the less frightening you look, the better. Because he don't know you could unlock your jaws and bring him to Christ. Snakes are never afraid of the size of the prey. Number four, very important. Snakes study their prey. Now, Christ knew this. When a snake is going after prey, the snake never attacks the prey. That's why you should never go directly to the jugular vein of salvation. A snake. My research shocked me. They said a snake will watch a prey for 5 to 10 hours. Can you wait that long before you strike? Can you talk to someone for 2 hours before you get down to the point? In other words, a snake watches its prey. Now, here's why they say they watch the prey. Write this down. The snake studies the prey. You got to study the people you're supposed to reach. Study. What's he studying? He's studying the bird, how it jumps. Every time it jumps, how far it jumps. What happens when it does jump? How does it land? Okay, now, and then, does it jump in a circle or does it jump in a straight line? In other words, it's studying before it strikes because it has to somehow figure out the move before it moves. He said, do that when you're going to win people. Study people. Study what makes your boss depressed. Why? Because you know how to catch them at the moment where they need God. Study what makes them angry. What makes them happy? Study how much they need a cigarette, when they need it. Study it. Study your own family. Study why your brother ain't saved. Just watch him. Don't attack him for God. That ain't what you want. You want to study your sister. Why is she away from God? Why does she backslide? Study her. You'll be amazed what you find out. You might be the cause why she backslid. Study the people before you attempt to win them. Sometimes you got to study for a long time. Sometimes you got to go visit somebody, not to get them saved, just to get them prepared. And then go home.